ain't no gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here with another video. If you can't tell already, I am a little sick, so I'm going to be a little snuffly and whatever. Today we are on Outcast Farms, which is an edit of Windchaser, not Westbridge. So... yeah, we're doing corn harvest here. I'm not going to do a tour of everything right now. We're here on field 2 combining corn. And then I got two New Holland CR990s. Yeah, CR990s with 12-row corn heads on hired worker. They're on auto combine. One is running the north section up there, and then one is running this south section here. And then we got two W900Ls with Wilson hopper trailers, tandem dollies, and 36-foot doubles. And then that I run. And then running the T9450 and Kinsey 1050. Maintaining the combines. let's see. So our one truck is full and the other is... the front trailer is about 80% full, so, and then I did a few edits to this map, and I'm also going to do a few more. What I did is I removed, the auger that was at the three small bins there, and then deleted the one conveyor system on those bins. Because I'm using the Farm King auger to run, to unload. So, I just moved that stuff so that it wasn't in the way of the Farm King. Which is the reason why I'm running the trucks. Rather than just having Courseplay run the trucks while I ran Grain Cart. So yeah, I get a... fair amount of leg looking at the farmyard, because that shed there and the shed over there are packed full of equipment. Most of it's actually Joe Lindbergh's equipment too, but some of it's like other miscellaneous stuff. I'm also gonna be changing the gravel texture, and then I'm gonna be changing the corn and soybean textures as well. I had changed them before, but I didn't think of it. I forgot to change some stuff in the i3D file for the map in Notepad++. So that corn texture didn't work, because in order for that corn texture to work, there's some stuff you have to change in the i3D and Notepad++. So I had forgotten to change that, so it didn't work. But so excuse me, what I've kind of got an idea of doing is I do two videos Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. So what I'm thinking of doing is doing videos on this and Missouri River Valley and my work in progress map. This is your Saturday video, but I'm recording it on Thursday. So today I just put up a video of my my map, just kind of the first video showing you guys around it, and explaining how it works, and what its features are right now, what features it's gonna have, all of that stuff. And so what I'm thinking of doing is Tuesdays and Thursdays will be farm sim. So like maybe, this is an example, which it's probably how I'm going to end up doing this. Tuesdays, I'll have videos on Missouri River Valley. And then Thursdays, I'll have videos on this map. And that's actually what I am going to do. just kind of mix it up a little bit so it's not the same thing over and over for now. And then Saturdays, I'll do updates on my map. So that'll be starting not this coming week, but the week after. This week, you won't have a video until Saturday because I have a GED test coming up on Wednesday. So I'm going to be studying for that and then taking that. So you won't have a video until a week from today, you know, the time that you're seeing this video. So you won't have a video until the 14th. Yeah, until the 14th. And that'll be an update on my map. Because hopefully by then I'll have done a little work. And, you know, then I can kind of just show that off a little bit and show you guys what I did. So I'm just going to kind of make this guy's turning a little different here. So, yeah, that's what I'm thinking of doing now. So we will, we'll be putting that into action in 2 weeks. Well, I guess in a week, but yeah, so we'll get this guy going again, and we'll go ahead and unload the grain cart. And then our truck should be fairly full. Yeah, so this map does have soil mod on it, so we've got equipment to deal with that. Maybe once the trucks are full, while I wait for them to unload, maybe I'll do a little bit of farm tour stuff. We'll see. Or actually, I guess once we get this unloading, I can kind of give a tour. It'll be a little bit before the combines are full again, to the point where they need to be unloaded. Fill this trailer first before we leave, and then I'll give you guys a tour of the equipment. Alright, so the front trailer's full, now we'll go ahead and fill the dolly. So, up here in this shed in the main yard is where I have all of the tillage equipment. So we'll start off here. We have the Thunder Creek fuel trailer that Joe Lindberg released. That's his, the one that he converted over, added dirt to, and added damage repair to. We got the GMC 3500. And then we'll just tab back into the shop here. We got the New Holland T8-320 to run our Mandaco LR45. Junior 9560R on 2720. And then we got a 9420 on the 2730. And then we got a 2623 disc with a T9450 Realtree Row Track to run that. And then we'll just hop over into this shed. We got the Rogator 1386 sprayer, or fertilizer spreader, excuse me. Patriot 3230 sprayer. We got my tender trailer, the Freightliner FLD 120. We got the Versatile 305 running the 1770 John Deere planter. And then we got the 379 heavy haul on the low boy here. XL Specialized Trailers low boy. And then if we go, we forgot to remove those doors. Oh, that door doesn't open. And then over here we got the John Deere Flex Wing Air Seater hooked to the T9 450 ATI Realtree. And then we got the 9560RT running the Kuhn Kraus 5635 and Great Plains Soil Conditioner. And then here we got the John Deere 4840 running the Farm King Auger. And this is the reason that I had removed the auger that was here and then the trigger, because then I can use this. And then as you can see, I removed conveyors up there. We got two New Holland Draper headers. These are the 45 foot in-game ones. And then that's actually it, yeah. We own fields 1, 2, 3, 21, and 20 at the moment. So all of these fields here around the farm. And then we'll expand further here soon. And eventually get into beef as well. So I actually have to take a quick pause, so I will be right back. Alright, and we're back. We're going to go unload our combine. So the combine on the bottom, right there, that's 65% full. That's this guy right here, so we'll get him unloaded first. And then by then, the other guy should be about this amount full as well. So yeah, we're running a lot of ground right now so far, and we still have a lot of ground left to harvest, along with a lot of future ground as well. There's definitely a large map. This is, the size of this map is the same as what the map that I'm doing will be. Only the fields probably won't be as large. You know, some might be, some may not be. Just depends on what it is like in real life. Because, you know, as I said in the video on the map, it's going to have exact same fields and road layouts for the most part, and that kind of stuff. So whatever is there in real life is most likely what's going to be there in the map. Alright, we'll go unload our other combine now. Let's see, where is that? He's coming down the side over there, so we'll wait for him to be going west. And then we'll unload him then. And we'll have to unload yet again the green cart, anyways. And then we can go unload into the bins. So I was gonna put these guys on course play, but I was having issues getting the two of them to run. I couldn't get the headers aligned for anything, so I just said, heck with it. Auto combine will work, but then when I get to the draper work, I'll be able to get those guys running together. Go ahead and get lined up on our GPS here. finish unloading this guy, and then we'll, if we still have room, we'll top off from the other combine. Which looks like we will. The other combine and top off. We will fill the last truck, and then we can start hauling to the bins. I have a feeling the GPS course is gonna fail me here, so yeah, it is. We won't be running with this guy very long. Not long at all. And we're full. Yeah, I'm also gonna change the ground textures on here, and then also attempt to change the stubble height for wheat and barley, and make it just kind of sit up a little higher. Get this guy filling onto the back trailer here, and then we'll take the first semi up to the bins, which is this guy here. Leave both of our trailers. Yep, both of our trailers are tarped, so we're gonna go ahead and head on over to the farm. Turn those things off for a screenshot. A lot of people have requested that I turn off my FPS and soil mod when I do screenshots, which I guess soil mod I don't really need on all the time anyways. So I wish these trucks had Jake brakes in them. I might have to figure out how to add that script and get it added into this truck. And a bunch of others as well that I have. Let's try and not hit the culvert and not hit the mailbox with our 36-foot double. We'll go ahead and get on up here. So this trailer empties out of both hoppers, but only one of the hoppers will actually be over the auger spout. It'd be pretty cool if you could actually unload one hopper at a time, but sadly you can't. So we're going to move this. It's gonna clip through, but I can't let that. Right about there, I think. Should do it. That's just about perfect. Except we're a little off. Driving over this, I guess. Not very realistic, but it's kind of difficult to just move it all the time. Alright, and then we will get the auger turned on. This stupid leg. Oops, that's not what I want to do. Thank you. We'll take a screenshot there. We're just gonna drive over it because I can't get lined up otherwise, so. But once we're done, then we can. Let this process the corn that's in the hopper yet. Turn it off. I'm actually just going to raise it up, I guess. And it won't clip through so much. Oops, wrong button. Make it hit C, not Q. Or X, whatever. Back up a little bit here so we can get around the tree. We're just going to park this guy up in the middle here. It's not quite a haul anymore. Alright, I'm going to get this guy started up. Get our trailers tarped. Head on to the farm and do the same. Whoa, what the heck is going on there? I got me hearing some kind of collision in the truck and trailer. See, our combines are only about 40% full. And the north one is 37, south is 42, so got plenty of time to unload our trailers, get the trucks parked. I'll have to put down that auger again. And we'll hop back into our truck here. And process again what's in the hopper with a jump auger there and oops, button again. Alright. hop on into the truck here. Back up a little bit. Warm into the field. Pull up by the other truck. And then unload over. Combines one more time, and then that'll be a video. And our next video will probably be... probably still be on corn, I'm guessing. Either I'll still be on corn, or else I'll be just finishing corn and moving over to soybeans. We're just getting ready to start soybeans, we'll see. Depends on how much time I get to play on this map. I also want to get some stuff done on Missouri River Valley. In my map, so... between these two combines, that'll fill our grain cart again, or either very nearly. The other combine now. Yeah, this tractor here is the one that was in the update of the T9450 pack, and there's also, we also did an update of the T97 pack and the CR990s, and I guess I really didn't look at what it said for changes. I just kind of went and downloaded them, didn't really pay attention to that. I know for sure, you know, with the T9450 pack, I know for sure that he added the road tractors in, and then he also added, he also has the indoor cab light added, and I think that's the same with the T97s. And I don't know what's all different with the CRs. I'd have to go back and look at the change log. Just about full, and that'll be a video then. So yeah, guys, as always, you for watching, and don't forget to check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video. Share the video for others to enjoy as well. And subscribe if you haven't already. Don't forget to leave your comments down below. I always enjoy reading and replying to them. And I will see you guys in the next video in about a week. So thank you for watching, and see you later.